Hello friends, many times when we go for the analysis, the first question comes in our mind is about the type of data and which distribution is the best fit for the data. This is a very important step before going for analysis. If we select an incorrect option for the analysis, then the interpretation of the results will be incorrect, which in turn initiates incorrect action and thereby incorrect results. To avoid this, now onwards, we are going to learn individual distribution identification to identify the best distribution or transformation for your data before you perform an analysis in Minitab software with the help of a practical example for easy understanding and better clarity. So let's begin. Individual distribution identification. The individual distribution identification is used to identify an appropriate distribution or transformation for your data before you perform the analysis. Many statistical analyses, such as capability analysis, are based on the assumption that your data follows a particular distribution. Individual distribution identification provides probability plots and goodness of fit test that allows you to do the following: to determine which of the 14 distributions provides the best fit of your data, and to determine whether a transformation is effective to fit your data to a normal distribution. For example, a quality engineer for a nutritional supplement company wants to assess the calcium content in vitamin capsules. The engineer collects a random samples of capsules and records their calcium content. To determine which statistical analysis is appropriate for the data, the engineer first needs to determine the data distribution. Therefore, the engineer performs individual distribution identification to determine which distribution best fits the data. Hypothesis for individual distribution identification. The hypothesis for individual distribution identification consists of two parts. Part 1, Minitab calculates Anderson-Darling statistics and the p-value for each distribution and transformation. For the Anderson-Darling test, the hypotheses are as following: H0 : data follows the distribution, and H1 : data do not follow the distribution. Part 2, Minitab performs a likelihood ratio test to determine whether by adding an additional parameter to the selected distribution significantly improves the distribution fit. For the likelihood ratio test, the hypotheses are as follows: H0 : the simpler model, that is smaller distribution family, fits the data well. That is, adding an extra parameter does not significantly improve the fit of the data. And H1 : the more complex model with an extra parameter, that is larger distribution family, significantly improves the fit of the data. Although it seems somewhat difficult, but don't worry, it is very simple to understand once we see this with the help of a practical example. Data considerations for individual distribution identification. To ensure that your results are valid, consider the following guidelines when you collect the data, perform the analysis, and interpret your results. 1. The data should be continuous. Continuous data are the measurements that may potentially take on any numerical value within a range of values along a continuous scale, including fractional or decimal values. Common examples include measurements such as length, weight, and temperature. 2. The sample data should be selected randomly. In statistics, random samples are used to make generalizations or inferences about a population. If your data is not collected randomly, then your results may not represent the population. Example of individual distribution identification. Let's continue with the same example. A quality engineer for a nutritional supplement company wants to assess the calcium content in vitamin capsules. The engineer collects a random samples of capsules and records their calcium content. To determine which statistical analysis is appropriate for the data, the engineer first needs to determine the data distribution. Therefore, the engineer performs individual distribution identification to determine which distribution best fits the data. conduct individual distribution identification in Minitab. To conduct an individual distribution identification in Minitab, please follow these steps. 1. Enter or copy the data for calcium content to Minitab worksheet in the column form as shown in the picture. 2. Select Stat, Quality Tools, and then Individual Distribution Identification. 3. In the option of Data are arranged as, select Single Column and then enter Calcium. 4. In Subgroup Size, enter 1. 5. Keep the default selection of Use All Distribution and Transformation as it is. This is because we are interested to see all distribution and transformations. 6. All the options in Windows, box-cox transformation, Johnson transformation, options and results, keep defaults as it is. And 7. Click OK in each dialog box to get the results. We will get the results of analysis in the session window and in graph window. Interpretation of results. Minitab displays a probability plot as well as p-value for each distribution and transformation. If a distribution is good fit for the data or if a transformation is effective, then the points on the plot follow a straight line within the confidence bounds and the p-value is greater than the alpha level. An alpha level of 0.05 is often used. For this data, the 3-parameter Weibull distribution having a p-value of greater than 0.5 and the largest extreme value distribution having a p-value of greater than 0.25 are a good fit for the data. The box-cox transformation having a p-value of 0.324 and the Johnson transformation having the p-value of 0.986 are defective for this data. After the transformation, the normal distribution provides a good fit for the transform values. The p-value for the likelihood ratio test, that is LRT, indicates whether by adding an additional parameter to the distribution significantly improves its fit. An LRT p-value that is less than the 0.05 suggests that the improvement is significant. Adding a third parameter significantly improves the fit of the log normal distribution having a LRT p-value of 0.017, the Weibull distribution having the LRT p-value of 0.000, the gamma distribution having the LRT p-value of 0.006, and the log logistic distribution having the LRT p-value of 0.027. These results also indicate descriptive statistics for all the records of calcium content, like number of non-missing values, the number of missing values, mean, standard deviation, median, minimum and maximum values, as well as skewness and kurtosis values. The method of maximum likelihood, that is ML, is used to estimate the values of the distribution parameters that maximize the likelihood function for each distribution. The goal is to obtain the best agreement between the distribution model and the observed sample data. Use the maximum likelihood estimates of the distribution parameters to understand the specific distribution model that is used for your data. In our example, based on the Anderson-Darling and the LRT p-values, the 3-parameter Weibull distribution provides the best fit for the process data. To understand the specific 3-parameter Weibull distribution that is used to model the data, the engineer examines the ML estimates for shape, scale, and threshold that are calculated for the distribution. This is all about the detailed illustration of individual distribution identification. We will see the next important topic with a practical example in the next video. For references, I have taken some part of this very detailed content from Minitab. Now to end, please like this video if you have found it useful, add your valuable comments and share this video to your friends and colleagues to improve and refresh their knowledge. If you want to get updates of such videos from my channel, please do not forget to subscribe it and click on the bell icon and select to get all notifications. And finally, thank you for watching.